What is going on, guys? DBG here, and today we're going a little bit away from the news bracket of this. We're going to be talking about which of these cards right here are going to be worth picking up. We're going to be looking at all of the cards in the Tis the Season Pass set, and we're going to be going into a lot more detail than we did in our like quick 8-minute video just going over the set. So we're looking right here at these cards. This is obviously the set right here, and we have got, we're going to look from the very start first, and this isn't really going to be who's worth picking up. It's going to be titled, but it's realistically what cards are worth getting excited for, if you get what I mean. Because like, we got to look at some cards because we might as well go and get ourselves excited for cards. So for Sean Elliott, he was on the 98-99 Spurs, wasn't he? Yeah. So for Sean Elliott, we can take a look at what he's like in game, because anyone who's on historic rosters, I think, has had the same releases. It's just the guys that have had different releases are some guys. Okay, what reels is that? Dribble Star is not the greatest. Release is good enough, though. It reminds me of Jordan Walsh. That's no great dribble style. Does he move? No. It's either basic or Embiid. Either way, though, he's going to be a nice catch-and-shoot player. He's 6'8", will be able to likely play the 2. Can he fade in any way? Yeah, it's all right. But yeah, he's probably going to be like a Jordan Walsh without the defense. But he's obviously going to be taller. So, look, he's going to be a really nice catch-and-shoot emerald. If that's what you're looking for, not the end of the world, but like, that realistically is what he is. He is going to be a catch-and-shoot emerald, not going to offer really anything dribbling-wise, and probably not going to be the greatest defender in the world. But he's still going to be pretty good at what he does. So next up, we have got Emerald Ralph Sampson. So Ralph Sampson is 7'4". The only thing they might do with Ralph Sampson is they might give him a 3-ball. Like, all these giants that they give 25 speed to suck. And I mean that. They all suck. And maybe, just maybe, we see a little bit better on Ralph Sampson. Maybe we see 40 speed. Like, even on 40 speed, he's still going to suck. Maybe we see that. Like, he doesn't have any hot zones. Release is garbage. So, like, if they give him a 63 ball and, like, 40-something speed, I can't complain. Even though Ralph Sampson in real life was, like, you know the way they talk about Wemby right now? As, like, oh, he's going to be the greatest player of all time? Like, that's how they thought about Ralph Sampson coming into the NBA. They legitimately thought that the guy was going to be one of, if not the greatest player ever when it's all said and done. But he is still going to be 7'4". I'd like to see like 55 speed. By the way, he'd still stink with 55 speed. It just means that if you're on a budget and you're coming up against like Kareem, you're not destroyed. I don't understand in this game, why can players not hook with their right hand? I cannot shoot a post hook with a player's right hand. If I try to go right, it's a fade every time. Oh, there we go. I figured it out. I must obviously been holding in the stick the wrong way slightly. Yeah, I must obviously be angling it the wrong way. That makes more sense. But yeah, Ralph Sampson, he's going to suck. I hope he doesn't, but he's going to suck. Like, we all kind of know that Ralph Sampson is going to absolutely suck. I think Emerald Doug Collins, if I'm not mistaken, that Philadelphia 76ers team that he's on are in the game. So I'm going to be... I don't know if he's going to be on the all-time Sixers. Edit lines up. Is Doug Collins on the all-time Sixers? He is on the all-time Sixers. Perfect. Perfect. So we can see what he's like in-game. So far, we haven't seen anyone to get too excited about for the lower tiers. Oh, really? Basic dribble style. Chick! Oh, what a release. 2K, if you're watching this video, please just don't give him basic dribble star. This release is unbelievable. What release is this? This release is unreal. I'm like incredibly surprised. Nah, this is like a A tier release. Cool. he's gonna suck as far as movement wise goes, because the guy cannot burst. Oh my god. At least he can shoot. At least he can shoot, I guess. That is something that I'm gonna say it is gonna, could be a bit iffy. It could be very, very iffy with that dribble style. He needs a better one tomorrow. If he doesn't get a good dribble style, there is a good chance that every single one of these emeralds suck. Which is going to be very disappointing, because I am a budget guy and that's all I really care about. All I really care about is there anyone that I can get on a budget? So now we have got ourselves Shane Battier. That is a normal dribble style, I think, which I don't mind. That release is lovely. That's a beautiful release. That is an absolutely beautiful release. Doesn't look the greatest, but it's so smooth. It's like one motion. With latency, maybe it could be a little bit tricky, but the upper looks good. It's a high release point. I think last year, what release? Did they give him O'Shea Brissett last year? Because I remember using Battier, like his Opal. No, they gave him Sabin Lee, which is like one of the fastest releases in the entire game. He was so, like, his release was just so fast. Like, that Sabin Lee release was just one of the quickest releases in the game. And they gave him the Curry slide, which I liked last year. But he doesn't have the Curry behind the back. Here's a Dame one, though. Gonna be a good shooter. And, like, this is the release on normal timing. When this release gets put on quick, it's gonna be really good. So, last year, the release was obviously Isaiah Roby, Luke Kennard. It looks like Luke Kennard upper. Probably what it is. With his defense, he's going to be elite. You've got absolutely incredible defense there in Shane Battier. He's going to be elite. Then we got Rolando Blackman. So I don't know how great Rolando Blackman's going to be. And I don't even know if he's... Yeah, he's on the all-time Magic anyway. Because his release last year, I didn't really like. I was not the biggest fan of Rolando Blackman. So... It is whatever the dribble style J.R. Smith has. Oh, that release is disgusting. Oh God. No, that release is absolutely disgusting. It's not horrendous off the catch. He has basic fade. So he's going to shoot awful slow fades. No, man. No, Rolando Blackman's a no. Rolando Blackman for the Sapphire is an absolute 0% chance you should be excited for this guy type card. So I would not be a fan of him, to be honest. Now we're going to be looking at Dennis Johnson. I assume he's on the all-time Thunder, considering he won Finals MVP for them. Yes, he is. Dennis Johnson's not going to be much of a shooter. He never is in 2K. Last year, he won the best release in the game. This year, he does not have one of the best releases in the game. It's not bad. It's quick. Real quick. Last year's was so easy to green. And this year's isn't too bad either. Check out the dribbling. That basic dribble style, yeah. He's either gotten basic or what's he called, a dribble style, Joel Embiid. So yeah, if this doesn't change the card, regardless of his defense, and even if they give him a three ball, if he can't move, he's going to suck. Then we got Ruby Brandon Roy. We've all used Brandon Roy. We all know what Brandon Roy is like. So as far as like this goes. The thing is, I'm looking at Brandon Roy's stats, and I think they're going to, if they slightly nerf the offense, we're actually looking good. They can probably give him, instead of a 90 dunk, an 80 dunk. Instead of 88 speed, 82 speed, instead of an 86 three ball, an 82 three ball. And that would probably push him down. If they nerf his defense, he's going to be a glass cannon. Really good release, though. Really good animations. And for those like myself who didn't get Brandon Roy, it's a good time to get a Brandon Roy card. Now we're going to look at Bob Pettit. Bob Pettit is going to be, like, obviously one of the best players. Probably the best player in the history of the Atlanta Hawks. Him or Dominique Wilkins. Probably was Pettit, but obviously Dominique Wilkins is more recent. So Bob Pettit is going to have basic dribble style, which is to be expected. I don't like the release as much this year. He used to have a really high release point. It's not terrible. Like, the bass is still the same. His upper is just weird this year. Like, it used to be a really high release point, upper and really easy to green, but I do like the bass. I think that old set shot 14 is still one of his most consistent shots to green. Or consistent bases in the game, like, as far as greening is concerned. He's going to be a good shooter. He's going to get hot zones almost everywhere. He's going to have a high three-point rating. His speed is going to be quite low, I think. Like, low 70s. And I don't see him being up to too much, to be honest. Now we got Jason Kidd. Like, Jason Kidd, his big problem is the jump shot. It's really, really hard to be, like, overly hyped on Jason Kidd just because of that jump shot. It's not as bad as other years. Like, definitely not as bad as other years. But, like, dribble style's pretty nice. He's going to move pretty well. They're going to probably give him a dunk. Fade's nice. It's just slow. It is still slow. It's not nearly as slow as other years. And the good thing is that... I don't know why he can't dunk. The good thing is, though, is he's probably going to be able to dunk. But he's going to be an elite defending point guard in the game. Nice pro behind the back. Layup's not the greatest, but I just think at this stage in the game with the likes of Cade Cunningham in the game, that becomes very, very difficult to use a Jason Kidd who's smaller, slower release, and just going to be the same price. So it's really hard to... It's really hard to go out there and basically just say, oh yeah, go and use Jason Kidd when there are 100 times better options, unless Jason Kidd is your favorite player. And obviously, the caveat for all these is, like, if it's your favorite player, it's your favorite player. So for Elgin Baylor, nice enough dribble style. Oh, that's unusable. That's unusable. 2K, please change this release. Like, that is unusable. That's one of the worst releases in the game. It's Brook Lopez base. It is unusable. Like, it is not, it's not even just bad. It is an unusable release. You can be contested from under the basket on that. No, unless Elgin Baylor gets a release change, the guy is an grade A trash can. You should never, ever, ever want to use Elgin Baylor. Unless 2K have gone, like, out of their way and they changed the release, you should never in a million years consider using Elgin Baylor. I don't care how big a fan of, like, the Lakers you are. If you want to be a fan of the Lakers, cool. And you want to use, like, a small forward, an undersized, well, let's say undersized. This guy's not an undersized small forward. Elgin Baylor is. If you're a fan of the Lakers, you get this guy. Like, dribbling, pretty, I think that's normal dribble style. Release is good, at least. He's going to be bigger, he's going to be stronger, he's going to be faster, he's going to move better, and he's going to dunk. He's probably not going to move better. I don't know why I said that. Elgin Baylor, in fairness, is a decent dribble style. Bad behind the back there for Worthy. But I do like the release. He's going to be big. He's going to shoot the ball well. I'm pretty sure it's the same release as last year. Still pretty nice. Like, a little bit slow. He hangs on to the ball for a little bit too long at, like, the top of his jump. But still, I'll say it. Good card. Genuinely, genuinely good card. He'll be fine. And now we're on to the cards that everybody cares about. We're on to the three diamonds. So, we're on to these three cards right here. Seeing them, Ray Allen, Ron Artest, and David Robinson. So I would say David Robinson is more than likely going to be the guy that most people are happy about in this. So David Robinson, obviously, the guy's not going to dribble. He's never really been able to dribble in 2K. So he's not going to be like Hakeem. He's not going to be like Hakeem with the pro dribble style. The jump shot, though, is beautiful. Like, if that release... if he's got a 73 ball, he's hitting almost everything. Like, that's one of the better big man releases in the game. It's still the same as it always is. Is he caught? Does he have a nice off-dribble fade? Yeah. Yeah. So, like, if they go and give David Robinson a 73 ball and, like, 80 speed, probably looking at the best center in the game, you know. Hakeem might have to move to power forward. Because Hakeem is better than I thought he was. And, like, he might be better than Kareem. Yeah, as good as Kareem is defensively, he might be better than Kareem and Giannis. That release is beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. Ray Allen, like, we know what we're going to get with Ray Allen. We know what we're getting with him. There's no point in like being overly like, oh, should we get Ray Allen? It's like, we know exactly what we're getting with him. He's going to shoot the ball. He's not going to shoot the ball as well as Swaggy P. Unless you're locking in, or Ray Allen is your favorite player, just don't. Genuinely, like, unless you are locking in, there is just no reason at all to get Ray Allen. And like, I think Ray Allen is a pretty decent card. So for some reason, Ron Artest, when I'm trying to shoot around with him, is not in rosters. Ron Artest is going to have a decent release. And that's really about it. He's going to be decent on defense with a good release. And that's really about it. Like, he's not going to be your like guy to run through. Like, Trey Dribble Saw is pretty good. He's got Rudy Gay release, and I don't like Rudy Gay release. Just putting it out there. Like, if you like Rudy Gay, Ron Artest is going to be a better Rudy Gay than play the shooting guard. That's basically what you're getting. I don't think he's going to get many shooting badges. I think he's going to be fine. I think he's going to be perfectly, perfectly fine. But as far as diamonds go, look, D-Rob is the diamond. D-Rob's the diamond that everybody is excited for. D-Rob's the diamond that everybody wants. D-Rob's the reason why anyone's going to be happy if they lock in for Penny Hardaway, who is the last card. Let's see how Penny Hardaway is going to play. Is that Trey Dribble Style? Kind of reminds me of Trey last year. But I don't hate the release. I don't love the release. I don't hate it. I just don't see how he's going to be better than Cade. Bad behind the back. I don't know what the hell that was, but it's never getting open in a game. Fade's fine. Release is fine. There's just no way he's going to be better than Cade, right? Like, Shea might be better than both. And we're not in the rim run meta either. Like, if we were in a full-on rim run meta, because he does have that burst, which is pretty nice, and he's going to be a better dunker. And that's the one thing, is like, if you can get him into that double cross, he gets a lot off that push. That's maybe a good animation for him, but I don't know. If you've got the best team in the game, I don't know if Penny makes your best team. So, unless you are going for Kobe, unless you're going for Kobe, I just don't think it's worth it locking in for Penny Hardaway. I think he's just going to be fine. But D-Rob, if you want to save up for one of the cards, and you are an only spend player, saving up for D-Rob probably is not going to be a bad idea. So, as far as like Horde and MT, I would be projecting to wait, to be honest. I wouldn't be too excited unless you're going for David Robinson. Other than that, I honestly wouldn't be excited for any of these cards. If they're good, great. I don't think they're going to be good, if I'm completely honest, though.